I-130 Petition for Alien Relatives USCIS Stage Checklist for Petitioner and Beneficiary. Hello everyone, this is the Swamberg Channel. In this channel, we are sharing tips and how to reduce motivational quotes and blogs. Please do watch our video until the end so you won't miss any details. And please do smash the like and subscribe button for more upcoming videos. But before we dive into the video, I just want to let you know that this information are based on my experience, research, and publicly available information. If you want legal advice, you may consult an immigration lawyer. Hey everyone, are you a US citizen wanting to sponsor your spouse, parent, or a family member? The I-130 petition for alien relative is a first step for you. In this video, we'll break down the USCIS stage checklist, making clear the process for both petitioner and the beneficiary. What is I-130? I-130, officially called Petition for Alien Relative, is a first step for a family-based green card process. It's a form submitted to the USCIS by a US citizen or lawful permanent resident petitioning to an immediate relative or family to immigrate to the United States. I-130 checklist. First is you have to gather the evidence. This includes documents proving your US citizenship or a lawful permanent residency status, proof of relationship with your beneficiary, example like birth certificate, marriage certificate, passport information. Checklist number two. Complete the form I-130 and I-130A. If the beneficiary lives overseas, he or she no need to sign the form I-130A. Carefully fill out the form with accurate information about yourself and the beneficiary. USCIS provide a detailed guide and instruction for you. Checklist number three, file the petition and pay the fee. You can submit the application by mail or online. Make sure to include the required filing fee. We may apply our I-130 application, we only paid $535, but as of now, I think they already increased the price as of April 1, 2024. The application is, the filing fee depends whether you mail it or you do it by online. As of April 1, 2024, the online filing is $625 and the mail filing is $675. Checklist number four, respond to the USCIS request. USCIS may require additional evidence during the processing. You have to respond promptly to avoid delay. Checklist number five, await the USCIS decision. USCIS will review your petition and send a notification of approval or denial. The waiting time is like 10 to 14 months, depend on what service center handling your case. Our application, it took 10 months until we got approved. Documents checklist. Proof of US citizenship, example, a birth certificate, copy of naturalization certificate, a copy of the form FS-240 or CRBA, a copy of the US valid passport, or a proof from the U.S. consular office that you are a citizen with a valid passport. Proof of marriage, example like the marriage certificate or the PSA marriage certificate. Evidence of your spouse from a prior marriage, example divorce decree, annulment, or death certificate. 2x2 photos of the petitioner and the beneficiary. Must be a recent colored photograph. I would just add a quick note that if you filed it online, you don't have to put a signature at the back of your photos. But if you file it by mail, you have to put the signature or write the signature at the back of your photos. Additional proof of marriage. In this part, you have to prove that you have a bona fide marriage. You have to be specific with the evidence, such as marriage certificate, shared finances, joint assets such as land or property. If you have children together, you must have the birth certificate. Affidavit sworn of a third party that knows your relationship, and it must be notarized. And you have to do the relevant documentations of your ongoing relationship, such as pictures together, hotel booking, air tickets, remittances, chat logs and video logs. You have to be authentic and creative on how you're gonna convince the USCIS that you have a bona fide marriage. This is a simplified overview based on my experience. Consulting an immigration lawyer is highly recommended for your entire process. If you have any questions, just leave a comment in the comment section below. And if you find this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe for more valuable content. Thank you and God bless.